those passes down today.
Everybody on the blitz.
Quick pass is complete to the 15-yard line. Curtis Conway and a first down.
Hey, it helps to be 6'5", and well, Vinny's probably around 240 pounds. Look at the blitzers coming. That is what you call an all-out blitz. Again, the Jets, the adjustment this week is that they're changing routes. That time, Curtis Conway, he sees the blitz. Testaverde uses his size and experience to stand in there and throw a perfect pass.
Suddenly a test for this Philadelphia defense that has not allowed a point on an opening drive this year. Pass into the end zone. Incomplete, intended for Santana Moss. Number 26, Lito Shepherd, was there with him. It'll be second and 10.
Testaverde is just short with the throw. Lito Shepherd, a lot of people like to try to test him down the field. Santana Moss is in good position, but Testaverde underthrows it by about 3 or 4 yards.
You look at Philadelphia's red zone defense. Martin, right side, to about 13, maybe to 12.
There's so many ways, Greg, you know, I go back to this. There's so many ways to look at what the Jets are thinking about this week, and it's going to involve that guy, Jim Johnson. Because we asked him, what do you think about this quarterback situation? What do you want? And he goes, I don't know. I'm not sure. I don't want him to put that Chad Pennington guy in there, because that Testaverde, he's kind of got it going. And he always scares you, he says, about Testaverde, because his ability to throw the football. And he thinks now he's got back in rhythm and has thrown it very well the last couple weeks.
11th play of this drive. Quick drop, quick pass, incomplete at the 5. Wayne Trebek, the intended receiver, and that'll bring on the field goal unit.
Couldn't tell where this throw went. But again, Testaverde, because of his size, being careful, being smart. Wayne Trebek out last week. Probably a ball he usually catches.
30-yard field goal attempt now for Duck Bryan. The kick is on its way, and it is perfect. 9:20 to play in the first quarter. Jets draw first blood. 3-0 New York. It'll be Donovan McNabb's turn when we come back.
It earlier, Herman Edwards told us last night they had some plays specifically for Vinny Testaverde to run, designed to make him successful right off the bat, and that's a pretty impressive opening drive.
Yeah, it was. Now listen, you know, we keep talking about this quarterback rotation, but if Testaverde is outstanding, I don't think they'll rotate.
Short kick comes down to the 21-yard line. Brian Westbrook on the sideline and pushed out of bounds. It'll be terrific field position for Donovan McNabb and the Philadelphia offense. 26-yard return, and number 5 goes to work after this.
Here is the much-discussed Donovan McNabb.
A completion percentage of less than 50%. No touchdowns to his wide receivers yet this season. There is no question he has been a struggling quarterback. Yet the Eagles are 3-3, and he'll throw on first down. Over the middle. Complete to his tight end, number 89, Chad Lewis. Philadelphia's offensive line has lost Pro Bowl guard Jermaine Mayberry for the year to elbow surgery. Number 66, Bobby Williams, replaces him. The backs and receivers, the Eagles' trio of running backs, one thing in common. Fullback John Ritchie clears the way in front of them.
That's the biggest cheer I've ever heard for a completion over the middle, but I think they're just so excited. Brad Childress, the offensive coordinator. Donovan McNabb, we talked to him, and even Andy Reid, I think they're a little upbeat because he's really healthier now than he's been in the past few weeks. They're hoping that makes a difference.
Over the middle, completes another one. This one to the Jet 40-yard line, and this one to Brian Westbrook out of the backfield. The Jet defense now on the front line. Sean Ellis on a rampage. 8 quarterback sacks, the only guy in the league with a sack in every single game this year. The linebackers, a veteran crew. Mo Lewis, Marvin Jones, and Sam Cowart in the Jets secondary, manning the corners. A pair of 8th-year veterans, Ray Mickens on one side, and number 21, Aaron Beasley on the other. This is Correll Buckhalter, and Buckhalter finds running room up the middle to the 30. Dwayne Robertson and Marvin Jones with the stop after a four-yard game. It'll be second and six.
You know, Greg, go back to Donovan McNabb. You look at Vinny Testaverde limping just a little on the sideline, but I think you're always looking. It's been so tough on him down here that they're looking for reasons to be optimistic. And again, McNabb, he doesn't have the little bandages or the brace on his right thumb. He says that feels better. His foot, ankle, that's feeling better. So that just makes everybody think, well, I mean, he's going to play better, too.
Makes the Jet defensive line jump. He's going to go deep to the end zone. It is. No, ruled incomplete over the back line. Number 87, Todd Pinkston, was the man on the receiving end.
Pass is ruled incomplete. Offside, 92 defense. 5 yards, repeat second down.
That replay shows you left foot came down, right foot was out of bounds.
Good, quick thinking by the quarterback, Donovan McNabb, though. When you are sure the other team jumps off sides, then look down the field for your deepest receiver, and if there's any hope, you let it go. It's a perfect throw by Donovan McNabb. That would have done so much for the Eagles offense, for their team, for the fans, and probably most importantly for Donovan McNabb.
Second and one, this is Buchholder, and Buchholder spins inside the 30 for a first down. Well, Donovan McNabb, we mentioned much disgust, that's putting it lightly. He has been the object of an awful lot of angst from the media, from the fans here in Philadelphia, everyone calling for some sort of change. Andy Reid, to this point, he's my guy.
Never wavers, and I did not get even one hint from anybody down here, coach, organizational, anything, that they're thinking of taking him out.
There's a bullet net complete to L.J. Smith, the rookie out of Rutgers, the second-round draft choice, and the Eagles are inside the Jet 15.
He looks so much better, more confident as he drops back today. Just watch McNabb this time. Looks down the field, then he turns to the right, steps into the throw, and stepping towards the target is something I don't think he's done real well in this bad period of throwing the football. When he steps towards the receiver, he's throwing the football very well.
He's going to throw it again on first down. Stepping up, keeping it now to the 10.
If you throw the football well, it makes you feel good. And when you feel good, you make good decisions. There is nothing like a confident athlete on the field, especially if he's very capable, and that's what McNabb is. He's capable. Everybody's complaining, too, well, he's not running like he used to. Well, one of the reasons why it's not as good is because he's not throwing as well. So you can imagine some of the thoughts he's having as he drops back to pass.
This is Correll Buchholzer. Left side, ducks inside, touchdown.
Well, Donovan McNabb comes in. He feels better. He's going against the defense that's basically in the middle of the pack in the NFL. That helps him. But one thing that's been very consistent with this Eagles team, they have been running the football very well the last few weeks. John Ritchie leading the way, leads for Buchholzer to get the touchdown.
Buchholzer's third rushing touchdown of the season. Akers on for the extra point. Five and a half minutes to play. Buchholzer's 6-yard run has the Eagles on top, 7-3.
Welcome back, everyone. It seems we talk more often than not about the quarterbacks because of you know who, but today there really are legitimate quarterback stories. They're very intriguing here.
Oh, absolutely. I think that's the main focal point of this game, Greg. And one we just saw, Donovan McNabb, wonderful first drive. Even the crowd got behind him as they picked up those first two first downs. So That is bad news for the New York Jets.
I think you said it right. Those first cheers for his first two completions were derisive, and then they turned genuine. Akers kick from the two. It's Bates. The 20. And out to about the 23 or the 24-yard line. L.J. Smith with the stop, 21-yard return, and once again, Testaverde will take to the field. How's Vinny been performing? Well, take a look. His first three games, and we go back to that riding the bicycle thing. Everyone says, well, you've been doing it for 17 years. You're a 39-year veteran. You ought to get the hang of it. And Herm Edwards said, you know, his arrival in training camp, he had to change his whole mindset.
Well, that's right. And, you know, the people that say, well, you've done it for all this time, you should get right back in the flow. Never play quarterback in the National Football League. Even when you play all the time, it's hard to get in the flow.
Testaverde gives to Martin, and Martin out to about the 28-yard line. And keep in mind, it was Chad Pennington who took the majority of the snaps in practice this week for the Jets.
That's right. You know, and too, Greg, I said it after the last drive. If Testaverde has really outstanding success, I think Herm Edwards will keep delaying when he will put Chad Pennington in the game. But there's a lot of reasons. We'll talk about it as it comes up. But also, Herman Edwards is going to wait, and maybe when he thinks that his team needs a lift, he brings Chad Pennington in and gives him that emotional surge.
Martin will earn back. Gets the handoff and goes down at the 22-yard line, courtesy of N.D. Kalu.
N.D. Kalu is a very good outside rusher, number 94. But what the Eagles believe in, and Jim Johnson, everybody just get up in the field. Try to get in the backfield if you see a runner grabbing, but otherwise run to the quarterback. And that time, Indy Kalu runs right into Curtis Martin.
Loss of five on the play, a third and 11 facing Testaverde.
Hey, you.
On the roll, being chased, throwing for Krabet. He's got him out of bounds, just shy of the 40-yard line. It's enough for a Jet first down.
I tell you what, even Testaverde's pumping his fist on this one, because this is some throw. The Jets do an outstanding job. This is an outstanding play call because it's a different look. Three down linemen, three defensive linemen down. They come with another all-out blitz. They have the sprint-out pass, and Testaverde on the run makes a perfect throw.
Number 74 is the starting guard, Brent Smith, on the sideline.
All right, here with you.
Plays for Vinny Testaverde. What an excellent job by the offensive line, by Curtis Martin, carrying it up in there and waiting to the last second. Look at the blocking by the Jets offensive line, and everybody's open down the field, especially Santana Moss.
60-yard touchdown pass off the flea flicker. That is the longest play allowed by the Eagle defense this year. Attempt is good. 3:25 to play in the first quarter. Vinny Testaverde, the touchdown pass, the celebration, and the man who eventually will come in to replace him isn't too sad about it at all. Jets in the lead again.
Slam dunk decision to use CBS Sports Line. They offer games for every level of play, from beginner to expert. Join the league or start your own today by clicking on fantasy at cbssportsline.com.
Go ahead. They just showed me up on the screen here in Philadelphia, and they booed me again. But like I told you,
you made Donovan McNabb feel really good.
They hate me so much down here, they really like me. Do you understand that?
No.
Oh, I'll explain it to you later.
Westbrook and Morey deep for the kick. From the 6th is Westbrook. 25, tripped up across the 30, out to about the 32-yard line. Victor Hobson with the tackle. Santana Moss on the receiving end of the touchdown that has the Jets in the lead by three.
European football. It's only at NFL.com or at NFL on AOL.
Eagles begin at their own 32-yard line. Brian Westbrook in the backfield behind McNabb calling the signal. Westbrook running along the right side, 35. Out to the 40-yard line, a couple yards shy of a first down. Marvin Jones with the stop after an 8-yard gain. Let's go down to Armin. Armin.
Thanks, Greg. You know, talking about Donovan McNabb and his well-documented struggles those first two games of the season, Andy Reid telling us on Friday, had a chat with Donovan and said, basically, you might be the man here in Philadelphia. You might even be the Michael Jordan of the NFL, but you have to remember what got you here fundamentally. Donovan saying, basically, I went back, I looked at film, I found my balance and the pocket was off. He's corrected it, and as we saw in that first drive, Greg, he certainly feels like he did last year. Back to you.
Armin, thank you. Westbrook looking for first down. He's very close to it. We'll check in with Jim Nance in New York.
All right, thanks, Greg. In overtime, Panthers at the Saints. It's Casey from 31 yards out for the winner. And how about this, Phil Simms? Carolina is 3-0 this year in overtime games. Let's go back to you.
Well, all right, Jim. I'm glad you told me that. But it is. Well, that tells you a lot. To win overtime games, defense, wonderful kicking game. Two good reasons why you can win overtime games.
McNabb still with the football. Throws on the run, in and out of the hands of Todd Pinkston, his wide receivers, and that has been a huge problem here in Philadelphia. Dropped passes. Andy Reid said, when I got here, it was a problem. We eliminated him. Those problems seem to have crept back in.
Well, there's so many things happened, Greg. We've said so much about Donovan McNabb, so much about what he does, his confidence. So if he starts missing throws, wide receivers, everybody's going, well, why aren't you catching more passes? And they get uptight. Then the football finally comes their way, and you don't relax and catch it. And I do believe the fact that they haven't caught enough, gotten the rhythm of the game, makes it harder for them to catch it.
This is Deuce Staley. And Staley's piled up at the 47, maybe the 48-yard line. Interesting thing. Armin was talking about the approach for Donovan McNabb and what he told us. You know, we asked him, well, what do you think about all of this swirl of controversy and criticism? And he said, I don't listen to it. I don't read it. I don't pay attention to it. I've never lost my confidence or my personality, and that's what's keeping me in this.
Yeah, you know, he actually said to us, he goes, I go around and reassure my teammates, don't worry, everything's okay, because they read, they watch, they listen. So it bothers your teammates sometimes.
McNabb hangs in, hits a wide open receiver over the middle, and that's Freddie Mitchell inside the Jet 35 to the 34.
You know, and I'm not saying this as a slap of the New York Jets defense, but I think McNabb being healthy, seeing what they saw this week on the film, that there were going to be chances to have success throwing the football down the field. And so far, we have seen that. Wide open that time, Freddie Mitchell over the middle of the field.
First down, Eagles. McNabb still has it. Stepping forward, and now he gets sacked by number 94, John Abraham.
As I talk about that Jet defense, I think it does have some holes in it. It is not the fastest defense in the NFL. In fact, it might be one of the slower ones, but what has really saved it is the front four, the pass rush, John Abraham, Sean Ellis. They're having good years. They get fresh up the middle. That has covered up some of the problems behind them.
Herm Edwards says Jason Ferguson has been solid in the middle, and Dwayne Robertson is the rookie first-round draft pick that the Jets feel is coming on. Final seconds of the first quarter have wound down. That's the end of the first quarter with the score. The Jets 10, the Eagles 7. We'll come back to Lincoln Financial Field right after this. You're watching the NFL.
For the start of the second quarter, Donovan McNabb off of a good first quarter, and particularly here in Philadelphia where the fans are known to be a bit harsh at times.
No, they're soft.
Probably as important,
happy-go-lucky
to McNabb as anyone, that he got off to a good start in the first quarter.
I think you've missed better.
Second and long. Over the middle. That's complete. L.J. Smith, the tight end, to the 31-yard line.
You know, it's interesting. We talk so much about all this, and we'll continue to talk about with this offense of the Eagles. It has struggled. Andy Reid calls the plays. We asked him a lot of questions on Friday. He says, look, same offense, not going to change. You're going to keep calling the plays. We'll keep firing it. And he just said to me, Phil, sooner or later, we're going to get hot. And he has to go under that premise. This quarterback, McNabb, has taken him to two NFC championship games. Most of these players, it's the same offense. They helped him get to that championship game. He's going to let them play their way through it.
Third and eight. Throwing over the middle. Complete to Brian Westbrook. Westbrook to the 20 and a first down for the Eagles. One of the things that Andy Reid pointed out is, hey, this has not been all Donovan McNabb's fault. And you said, well, it's very easy to figure out why that's true.
Well, here would be some of the reasons why, just watching him and studying it. McNabb's made bad throws. He's made some poor decisions. Greg, you talked about the drop passes. Then they get him open. He sees the open receiver. He's not pass protected. And then all that happens, it takes away Andy Reid's faith, and it makes it much harder for him to call plays and take advantage of what he sees.
McNabb throws, and that's complete for Richie out of the backfield. To about the 18.
You know, and I hope that all makes sense, because that's what happens on a football team. One little problem leads to another problem, and it just keeps going down. And before long, it's just a mess, and it's what it's been. And last week, they were horrendous against the New York Giants, but they still found a way to win the football game. And today, it kind of turned around so far.
What you're saying is senseless to point to one guy and say this is the single problem with the football team at this time.
Yeah, that's right. Even though it has a lot of its stem from it.
Pass far side is complete inside the 15. James Thrash. Forward progress is going to be marked almost to about the 11.
Well, throwing footballs to the wide receivers, getting good pass protection, throwing in rhythm, and being accurate with his throws. All positives for the Philadelphia Eagles so far today.
Boy, I thought they were really generous with the spot. But the line of scrimmage is the Jet 11-yard line. McNabb distributing the ball to six different receivers thus far. The pitch coming around. McNabb trying to throw a block to Thrash, who ducks inside the 10 to about the 7. It'll be first and goal.
The offense is boring. They don't do enough things. They don't take enough chances. Come on, we want to see more. Well, you know what? When you do the simple things well, all of a sudden, now you can call the wide receiver reverse, having the quarterback lead the way, because you've got into the flow of the game. It's hard to be creative with play calling if you're going out there and it's 1-2-3 punt.
First and goal.
Did I sound like a fan?
You did.
Yes, thank you.
This is Buckholz. Their second rushing touchdown of the day, and the Eagles are back on top.
If you want to run the football outside, one of two things, tight end and the fullback, the lead blocker, have to be good. John Ritchie gets a block. Chad Lewis does a good job in the line of scrimmage, allows Buckholz to get outside, break a tackle for the touchdown.
For the extra point. It's good. 11:36 to play in the first half. Buckholz's touchdown run. Donovan McNabb engineers another touchdown drive. 14-10 Eagles.
You know, Andy Reid likes to see if his team can answer right back. The Eagles did just that. 12 plays, 68 yards. Buckholz,
his second rushing touchdown of the day, in Philadelphia on top, 14-10.
And I thought both offenses would really struggle today, so I am not much in that predictive world.
Three, it's Bates. 25. And across the 25 to about the 27-yard line. And a chance for us to remind you tonight on CBS. A 30-year-old murder of a police officer caught on tape. Now, will recorded clues lead to his killer? Don't miss Cold Case tonight after 60 minutes on CBS. Vinny Testaverde still the quarterback. 11.5 minutes to play here in the first half. We asked Herman Edwards if he has a definite plan, and he said, no, no when.
It's all field. And if Testaverde doesn't make that
right
throw to Wayne Corbett, I believe he would have brought Chad Pennington in here in the third series.
Play fake, Testaverde over the middle. This is Martin. Martin out across the 35 and close to a first down. He may have enough.
And Testaverde makes that throw to Wayne Corbett on third down, Greg. Then what's he get? He now allows himself to get that flea flicker for a touchdown. And that play that you just saw, that is a quarterback that is now into the rhythm of being an NFL quarterback again. Testaverde looked down the field. He's under pressure. He scoots. And then something in your mind tells you, get rid of the ball real quick to the short receiver and throws it to Curtis Martin and gets a first down.
Could it be the pounding hoofs in your ears?
Well, that's, you know, that's right. Doesn't matter the reason, just as long as you listen to it.
Testaverde. Fine prediction on first down. Far side of the field, and that is in and out of the arm of the intended receiver, Santana Moss. It'll be second and 10.
Perfect throw by Vinny Testaverde from one side of the field all the way across to Santana Moss in a nice route. Nice. Testaverde's on the right side, throws it all the way to the left sideline. Santana Moss really did a good job of faking like he was going deep. That's why he was wide open. Or not wide open, but open.
Number 84, Jonathan Carter into the game, second and 10. Martin turns the corner left side. And close to midfield, up to midfield, and enough for a first down. Mark Cimino with the tackle. Jim Nance in New York.
All right, thank you very much, Greg. The Texans now with David Carr injured with an ankle, questionable to return. Tony Banks leads them, and it's Dominic Davis from 15 yards out. Good-looking rookie has him in front now. 7-3, second quarter. Back to Greg and Phil.
Jim, thank you. Dominic Davis had a heck of a day against these New York Jets last week.
That he did. You know, I just want to say this to Jim. If he wants to do some of those updates and talk to us, that's fine. Because I know he doesn't want to talk to that other group he's got in here, does he? So Jim, just talk to us. We like hearing from him.
First down. Martin. Still on his feet and now pulls his way to about the 46. Nate Wayne, Mark Cimino with the stop.
Well, you know, you look at Curtis Martin carrying the football. The Jets doing a really impressive job of running it so far today. But Curtis Martin, off to a slow start, we brought it up to Herman Edwards, and he just said, hey, he's always a slow starter. And you can tell by watching him that he looks quicker, faster, smoother, all of it, and that's why he's being more productive on the field.
Lamont Jordan try the right side now. Penalty marker flies as he cracks the 45 to the 43. Our referee today is Jerry Austin.
Gerald. Well, Jerry is it.
It is Jerry.
Holding. 79 offense. 10 yards. Repeat second down.
That's a penalty on 14-year veteran Dave Zott. These Jets, I believe that's their second penalty today. They come into the game with the fewest penalties in the NFL.
You know, you go, there's so many things that, when you talk about Curtis Martin, he's just different. And he believes in doing what's right for the team to help other people out. Look what he's done this season. The first four games compared to how well it's gone the last two. Something we haven't talked about yet, but the Jets play a lot of players. And Herman Edwards says, we play a lot of them because I need the energy that those substitutes give us when they come in.
Birdie gives to Martin, and Martin straight ahead. Martin still on his feet out in midfield. And what Curtis Martin does is he has agreed to give up some of his playing time to Lamont Jordan, which helps Herman Edwards in his plans immensely.
Greg, that's exactly right. The coach tries to institute a new plan to the team. And the first guy that says, yeah, we got to do it at running back. Lamont Jordan's got to come in. I'll come out. And now, what does anybody else on the team say when the substitute comes from them? Well, you say nothing. Because the star lets them substitute for him.
Big third and nine. throws back the other way. Curtis Martin is not going to get it. Wrapped up on the far side by MD Kalu and Nate Wayne for a loss of two.
Expecting a blitz. That's why they roll to the right. And, Greg, you know what this is. He goes this way. Everybody going to the offense's right. That's the old shoot screen. Chase the quarterback, and you go, oh, no. It's the other way, but the Eagles are not biting. You've got them with the flea flicker for a touchdown. They are not going to overcommit again.
Brian Westbrook awaits the punt. Dan Straczynski, and it's blocked. Ike Reese with the block. The Eagles cover at the Jets' 40-yard line. Coaches will take their boost from wherever they can get it, and Andy Reid gets one here from special teams.
Ike Reese, oh, was that a nice move by him? You know he's a good athlete. On third downs, he is brought in to help cover running backs and wide receivers.
Big change for the Philadelphia Eagles. Prime field position when we come back.
Well, the Philadelphia Eagles had begun to think that everybody except them gets to start a drive in the opponent's territory. Coming in, they had five of them, and that tied for the fewest in the NFL. Now they take over at the Jet 40-yard line.
McNabb gotten to from behind, and he's dropped by John Abraham.
How does Ike Reese block the punt? Watch 51 Quincy Stewart, expecting him to go outside. He fakes outside, comes underneath. Just a good move by Ike Reese to get the block.
A look at Ike Reese. There's Quincy Stewart. Meanwhile, Abraham's second sack of the day has the Eagles in the second and 16. And straight ahead is Westbrook. Westbrook's inside the 45. To about the 43.
Well, Greg, we talked about it, and the key, the big and only key maybe for this Jets defense is try to control down and distance somewhat. And if you think it's pass on first down, or if it's going to be pass on third down, Ted Cottrell, he knows to have success, it's got to be his pass rushers. The Jets have four number one draft picks on that defensive line, all drafted here in the last couple of years. They have to be the difference for the defensive side.
McNabb, third 14 under the gun again, and down he goes. Abraham and Jason Ferguson in on this one.
Wow. A known passing situation. John Abraham has the speed to go outside, but he has power where he can run through blockers as well. Shoot, three of them are trying to get to the quarterback that time. Sean Ellis and Jason Ferguson.
So Dirk Johnson will kick it away. Santana Moss is deep. High floating kick. And Moss pulls it in at about the 8 or the 7 yard line. We'll take a break. Come back to Philadelphia after this.
Emmy Lou Harris and the latest Survivor Castaway. Later this week, I'll miss Keanu Reeves, Doris Roberts, sex expert Sue Johansson,
and kids in Halloween costumes. Late show's all new all this week on CBS. And Herm Edwards has decided the time is now for Chad Pennington to make his season debut. Curtis Martin, right side, out across the 10 to the 12-yard line. And Chad Pennington, and there's been a lot of talk about his injury. It was not his wrist, it's his left hand, and he's wearing a protective cast on it. He says it helps him with the grip, and it also helps his confidence.
Yeah, he has that glove over the top. The glove is just to, because it is a little like a hard shell, just so if he does get hit on it, it will absorb the pain. You can look at it, and the glove, to help him with handing the football off and to grip it when he goes to throw.
His first pass is a quick slant over the middle, and that's complete to Gerald. Charles Soule, and that's enough for a first down close to the 25.
That's a nice start. It really is. And you think, oh, come on, it's a stupid little pass over the middle. No, it's a lot more than that. First, he takes the snap pretty well. Not a big deal. When it's your underneath hand, it doesn't hurt the quarterback near as much.
And make no mistake about it, Chad Pennington is the emotional leader of this New York Jets team.
Well, it was not going to be easy to put him in there, but Herm Edwards, even though they were backed up, says, let's do it. As he said last night, Jess, he goes, hey, God, this is the franchise. I got to get him in there.
Pennington, incomplete. 81 Curtis Conway appeared to have slipped on his route, and it'll be second and 10.
Well, let's look at some of the reasons why you put Chad Pennington in here. The team is 2-4, and as Herm Edwards, as I asked all these questions last night, he goes, hey, I know my guys. I know how to handle this. The age of the quarterback, the big difference. Everybody knows who's the number one, and that Vinny Testaverde's the number two. And most important of all, Chad Pennington is the franchise. He is their hope. They got 10 games to play, and he's going to be a big part if they're going to make a playoff run.
Martin left side and not much running room there. He's across the 25 to about the 27. Michael Lewis coming up to make the stop.
Now, you know, when I say all this, it's taken nothing away from Vinny Testaverde. For all the Jets fans and everything that's been said, he by far kept his end of the deal up. He played better than the New York Jets football team in those first six games. He gave them chances to win, but they never came through with those plays near the end when they needed them. But Vinny Testaverde, a backup quarterback, I thought he played very well.
Pennington looking at a third and 7, needs the 35-yard line for a first down. Oh, threads the needle complete to Krebet for a first down. 9-yard pickup and a fine pass by Pennington for the first down.
You know, you are right when you talk about threading the needle. Confident, seeing, and what really Chad Pennington's biggest strength. It's not his arm is real strong, but when he aims the ball, if he says he's going to throw it right there, wherever that spot is, he hits it. He is extremely accurate when he throws it.
Lamont Jordan into the backfield on first down. Pennington with all kinds of time throws it out to the far side. Jordan with running room. Takes on a tackler and wins the battle. Gets himself a first down close to midfield. Houston and the Colts doing battle. Jim Nance in New York. Jim.
All right, thank you, Greg. David Carr had to sit out a series against Tony Banks, led him on a touchdown drive, but Carr does the same thing. He flips it here to Billy Miller. How about this, Phil Simms? 14-3 Texans. Colts coming off a bye, and they are flat. Back to you.
All right, thanks, Jim.
I think Jim's lonely.
No, the heck, he know what it is. We just decided to get rid of you. We're going to do it ourselves.
And them. This is Jordan trying this side. And look across midfield to the 49-yard line. Pick up of 2. It'll be 2nd and 8, and that's where we'll resume things after the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to play in the first half here in Philadelphia. Eagles by 4.
Tim, Dan, Dion, and Boomer have today's scores and highlights all coming up on the Nextel Halftime Report.
Jets with the ball at the Philadelphia 49-yard line. Each team has all three of their timeouts remaining. A look at Donovan McNabb, who has had a good outing thus far here in the first half.
You know, too, as I've watched this, we talked to Jim Johnson, defensive coordinator. I kind of said some of the thoughts that he had, but he was going to do it by feel. And I think his first thought was, man, I'm going to blitz Pennington. But now that they've moved the football, he's gotten in the groove. You might have to be careful.
Pennington throws. Threads the needle again just inside the 40-yard line to send Santa Moss. 11-yard pickup, another first down.
Boy, it's pretty impressive. Starting at your own 7-yard line. Coming out, you haven't played since the preseason, the third game of preseason, and you just throw every football right on the mark. And Chad Pennington has squeezed 2 throws in against his Philadelphia defense.
Martin in the backfield on first down, play for Pennington. That one almost intercepted. Shepard, Nate Wayne each had a shot at it. Maybe that was the problem.
That was the problem. Really good job by the defense. It's a zone defense, so they're watching the quarterback. They see him look to his right, and they make a very good break to the ball. Nate Wayne is quick. He's fast, so he can get there. And Lidl Shepard had read it right, too.
More green on the receiving end of that than a Jet quarterback likes to see on the road. Second and 10. Straight ahead, running room for Curtis Martin. All the way to the 20. Timeout called, stopped the clock with a minute 10 to play in the first half. And the Jets looking for a go-ahead score.
Jets have two timeouts remaining.
And they find themselves in prime position at the Eagle 20-yard line. Curtis Martin, 74 yards rushing today. 88 is his season high.
The Eagles reacted very quickly to this screen to the outside. The New York Jets are hoping it's an incomplete pass. It was thrown to Santana Moss. Carlos Simmons, number 51, gets out there and makes the hit to cause the fumble.
Phil, you were just talking about Jim Johnson, the defensive coordinator. He said when they get the ball to Santana Moss, it's like a punt, and you'd better get there in a hurry.
Yeah, that's a good analogy, Greg. It's like a punt return, where when they throw it to him, there's space. He's good at stopping and restarting and making people miss, so they reacted quickly and caused the fumble.
Now we get a timeout called by the Jets. So with a minute 3, they use their second timeout. Herman Edwards will try to regroup the defense.
From the 22, McNabb.
Pump fake, and down he goes again at the 15-yard line. Looked like John Abraham again.
Well, that's really this Philadelphia Eagles offensive line. It's pretty good.
Eagles call a timeout to stop the clock. Well, the Eagles did not call a timeout. Clock still continues to move, coming up on a half minute to play. And this one is going to be Westbrook, near side, trying to turn the corner, and he's bumped out of bounds just as he crosses the 20-yard line. Jason Glenn with the defensive play after a 6-yard pickup. It'll be 3rd and 11, and there are 24 seconds to play.
Of course, what this does too, it's now on 3rd down. If the Jets, nothing happens, they can stop the clock, force the Eagles to punt, and maybe give themselves a chance to run a couple more plays.
That's exactly what Herman Edwards is telling his defense. By the way, happy Halloween.
I'm going to come down to your house and trick or treat. I know how much you like giving away that candy to kids.
McNabb fakes this way, shakes the tackler, and slides down at the 20. And immediately the Jets call timeout with 15 seconds to play.
And that's
15 seconds on the clock. Jets may have one more shot at points on the board before halftime.
Vaughn Ellis, who now has a sack in every game this year, 9 on the season, and the 10th straight regular season game with a sack. That ties the NFL record with Simon Fletcher.
What a tandem. John Ellis, John Abraham.
Off the side of his foot and out of bounds. And Dirk Johnson came up with his worst kick of the day at the worst possible time. That's a 17-yard kick. And the Jets will have 7 seconds to do something about this field position.
Well, there is a chance, Greg, with this little amount of time left, one quick throw, but you got to make sure it's to the sideline. If it's not there, you throw it away. And you try the long field goal.
Eagles have made a habit of allowing a field goal in the last half minutes, the first half.
Boy, look at Andy Reid. He is steaming because, well, so many things went against his football team there. Probably the sacks. Of course, he's upset about those. The kick out of bounds, but Brian Westbrook running out of bounds was the biggest play of all in that last few plays.
Doug Bryan, the place kicker for the Jets, has a long of 43 so far this year. Pennington throwing far side of the field, underthrew his intended receiver, Curtis Conway. And so on comes Doug Bryan, who is going to give it a shot from about 55 yards or so. Now Bryan has a career long of 56. You see it there. This will be a 55-yard attempt. Krasinski holds. The kick is on its way. It is short. Lots happening in the final 2 minutes of this first half. In the end, no extra points were added to the scoreboard. And Brian's attempt comes up a couple of yards short. It's a 14-10 Philadelphia lead. And Vinny Testaverde looking on from the sidelines, wishing it on, and sees it come up short. Let's go down to Armour.
Thanks.
Thing that Eagles fans expect of him, and of course the Jet defense that New York fans have come to know and love.
Well, the Jet defense, it's all predicated on the front four, like we said, Greg. They've got to rush Donovan McNabb, because you can see when he has time, there are open receivers down the field. And just to talk about all the quarterbacks in general, I think all three have played well, and I expect to see Chad Pennington start second half for the New York Jets.
Take a look at the numbers and you will see that the Philadelphia Eagles have managed just 103 total yards in the first half, and the Jets have more than doubled that. However, scoreboard is what's important. Look at the five sacks for the New York defense. It is a 14-10 Eagles lead.
Well,
at the break,
the perception is the Eagles did a lot better than an offense. I was surprised to see only 103 yards, but two good drives by them for touchdowns. That's why they're leading.
From the 14, Brian Westbrook. Westbrook to the 30. Up to about the 32 or the 33-yard line. Sam Garns with the stop. We check in with Armin.
Thanks, Greg. A final note on the Vinny and Chad story is Vinny came off the field what was going to be his final time with the Jets today. He went up to Chad and really sort of a passing of the torch moment. He touched him on the helmet. He shook his hand and said, well, basically, it's now in your hands, kid. And Chad told us yesterday, he said, the speed of the game is going to be the most difficult thing for me. He said, I can't worry about it. He said, I just have to get the ball into the hands of the people that can do something with it. He sort of picked up where he left off last year, Greg.
All right, Armin, thank you. On first down, the give straight ahead to Buckhalter, and Buckhalter brought to a halt close to the 35-yard line. Recap a look at what happened offensively in the first half for the Eagles. McNabb, 8 out of 9 for 76 yards. On the ground, it was Correll Buckhalter with 20 yards and 2 touchdowns. And the rookie tight end L.J. Smith with a couple of receptions for 24 yards on the receiving end. Last two drives, the Eagles minus 13 in total yards.
Back, that's what does it.
McNabb. That pass low. Sam Garns playing a little footsie with it before it got anywhere. It'll be 3rd and 8.
Yeah, covering L.J. Smith. We talked about, of course, we talked a lot about the Eagles' offense in the first half, but the way to get things going, Brian Westbrook, now the running back, he brings more speed, can make people miss to make those plays. L.J. Smith is getting more snaps at the tight end position, the second-round draft pick. He's fast, so he can take a short pass again and make a big play. And I was looking for Greg Lewis, the wide receiver, to get the snap, but not so far today.
McNabb over the middle, gets his man out close to the 50-yard line, and that is good for a first down to Freddie Mitchell.
It takes confidence in a quarterback that feels good about what he's doing to throw the football into tight situations. First, you can see that Donovan McNabb had space around him and a clear view of Freddie Mitchell over the middle and make the perfect throw.
The two previous third down passes saw McNabb get sacked. Fake to Staley. McNabb throwing to a wide open Todd Pinkston to the Jet 40 and another first down.
Well, shoot, if they keep throwing these passes down the field and hitting these wide receivers, what's everybody going to complain about tomorrow? But a good job, play-action pass, letting Donovan McNabb get away from the offensive line, free him up, let the receivers get down the field to get some space and see if they can get open for those catches.
See, four catches by wide receivers. That's Pinkston's first, good for 16 yards and a first down. Westbrook, and Westbrook trying the right side. How about an all-purpose back? Ryan Westbrook has a rushing touchdown in each of the last four games. He comes into this game number three in the league in total yards. Thought it was interesting when we talked to him. Only 5'8", 200 pounds. He says, you know, when you're a small back and you come out of college, people only think in terms of you as a specialty back.
Well, that's right. And he said he never doubted that he could come into the National Football League and be an every down player. He's limping off the field right now, but he says, I look to Tiki Barber, he's about my size. Marshall Faulk, he's no bigger than me, and well, he's proven that he can handle it over the last few weeks.
Buckhalter, right side. Fighting for first down yardage, and see how close he got to it. Marvin Jones and Sam Cowart combined to stop him.
You know, Greg, though, you go back, you talk about Westbrook, and I know he's on the sideline right now, but no matter what size you are, even if you're a big running back, if you're returning kicks, you're a big part of the passing offense, and you're the primary runner, that's asking a lot of any football player. That's a lot of punishment, and it's unfortunate that he's hurt.
Third and one. Buckhalter. Sam Cowart with the fumble recovery for the New York Jets, who stopped the drive with a turnover.
Sam Garns, the guy that created the fumble, number 42, makes the hit, and then he just pulls Buckhalter's arm away from his body and causes the fumble. The Jets, eighth in the league, at plus five in turnovers.
Pennington on the run, hits his man across the middle, and that's Anthony Beck, the tight end. That'll be enough for a Jet first down. Looking at the Jets in the first half offensively. Vinny Testaverde was 7 of 11 for 112 yards and a touchdown. Pennington, 5 of 8 for 42. On the ground, Curtis Martin rolled up 74 yards rushing on 13 carries, and Santana Moss, 60 of those 68 yards receiving on the touchdown pass from Testaverde.
Right here.
40.
You got to go. Houston!
Martin. Trying to change direction. Gets a couple of yards to the 42. Whiting and Nate Wayne with the stop after a two-yard gain. Incidentally, that's the second straight week now that Correll Buckhalter has lost a fumble.
Well, that'll knock your carries down when the head coach comes to call in the plays. But, you know, you look at Chad Pennington, he's back at quarterback here in the second half, and that's what I expected. But remember last night we were talking to Herman Edwards, and he says, when we really got cooking last year, when this team really took off, it's because they were running the football, which they're doing well now. And he says, our play-action passes, he goes, they were outstanding. And that's what Chad Pennington excelled at, play-action passes.
pulls it down and then hits his man Chris Baker, the tight end, across midfield and into Eagle territory for another Jet first down. And you know, Herm Edwards, here's another reason why. Everyone said, well, if you're going to start Pennington or if you're going to play him, why not start him? Chad Pennington is a very excitable young man. He told us last night that his biggest problem in the playoff game last year that knocked the Jets out of the postseason was that he was too fired up, too keyed up. He said, I really should have played linebacker that night.
Yeah, that's right. Well, usually when you're too keyed up at quarterback, if you take a really good hit, that'll settle you down. But yeah, with some good thoughts he said about that playoff game. And
Pennington again to Martin, and Martin is wrapped up for a loss by Hollis Thomas, number 78.
We said earlier the Eagles, they really rely on just getting up the field. Hollis Thomas, number 78, just fights through the block, gets away from Kareem McKenzie, gets in the backfield and makes the tackle.
Hollis Thomas missed all of last season with a foot injury.
But you know, Greg, go back to Chad Pennington. He says, it's amazing. He goes, I was all psyched up and emotional about that playoff game. He goes, I felt so bad walking off the field at halftime. He goes, I didn't even realize the score was tied. But, you know, because he just got emotionally bent out of shape a little and didn't control what he was doing on the football field as well as he should. And he said, something he learned from, and he's not going to let it happen again. Or try not to let it happen again.
Curtis Martin picked up 7 on that play, and it'll be a 3rd and 7 for Pennington and the Jets.
The Jets have done an excellent job today. And Paul Hackett, the offensive coordinator, he's the reason why. Picking up blitzes, finding receivers quickly when the Eagles do send the extra defenders.
Here comes the blitz. Quick pass. Gets Curtis Conway in the back.
Curtis Conway made a huge mistake. It was there. Perfect throw by Chad Pennington. The blitzers coming from this side. Nobody underneath. Curtis Conway was supposed to change his route, come across the middle. He did not see the blitzers coming.
Weren't we having a conversation about sight adjust last night?
We were. Right. You get sight adjust. Change the route.
James Thrash with the fair catch and then takes it out of bounds at about the 10 or 11 yard line. 34-yard punt and no return, and we'll be right back.
Do you have the right truck? The 2000
turn from gray to pink this month, joining the fight against breast cancer by helping to light the region's skyline pink as part of CBS 3 Philadelphia and the Susan G. Komen Foundation's awareness campaign, Light for the Cure. Eagles first down, their own 11-yard line. The give is Terrell Buckhalter running room right side. And out of bounds across the 30 before Ray Mickens knocks him out.
Good blocking up front by the Philadelphia Eagles offensive line. John Ritchie, the lead blocker, does a good job leading the way, but something you, if you're a Philadelphia Eagles fan, you've seen quite a few of these the last couple weeks. Creating good running lanes for the running back, and the Eagles have been very good at running the football.
Breathing room for the offense. McNabb, quick drop, quick throw outside, and that's complete to James Thrash. And while we have a moment, next Sunday, CBS invites you to the greatest live television reunion of all time with the stars who made TV history. CBS at 75, live next Sunday here on CBS. McNabb looking extremely confident, looking nothing at all like the quarterback that Eagle fans did not like the first 5 or 6 games of this season. Trying the right side, Duke Staley, and we go down to Armin.
Greg, an injury update on Brian Westbrook, who just left the field a few moments ago for further exam and x-rays on this injured left ankle. Also, the Eagles have suffered a significant loss on their defense. Mark Cimino, their middle linebacker, is out of the game right now with what are called vision difficulties, and his return is described as questionable. Back to you.
All right, Armin, thank you. Well, the loss of Brian Westbrook, and we talked about it in the first half, because He's so multi-purpose. He hurts you. The loss of a player like him hurts you in several areas.
Return game, his running, and of course, Greg, the other one is pass catching ability.
McNabb to Richie, and Richie fighting his way forward for a first down. Year in and year out, I don't think there's any question that one of the most entertaining people we get to talk to, no matter who he's playing for, is John Richie. One of the things that we've always found intriguing about him is the problems that he's had in the past with his helmet. When he was with a member, when he was a member of the Oakland Raiders, the helmet came down too low on his head, cut into his forehead, caused bleeding. And now he's found some relief here in Philadelphia with the way they make the helmets. This is Terrell Buchholter coming back this way. Gets a block from McNabb. Midfield and cut down just into Jets territory by Tyrone Carter.
When a running back cuts back, in other words, you start to the right and you just break it back to the left, it's just a feel that they have. They can tell the defense is over-pursued, nowhere to go, and then when you reverse field, you get a couple blocks, and Buchholter showing his speed, getting out and picking up those extra yards, and Donovan McNabb says, well, I'll help you out a little. And that's all you have to do is just get in the way.
John Abraham, that's crazy about it. Side the 45 to the 42. Let's go back to John Richie, though. I mentioned that he was entertaining, and as he was telling us about the problems with his helmet, he differentiates himself from everyone else, and he says because he's got a different head than everybody else is normal-headed people.
Normal-headed. It was incredible. We had 20 minutes on his head because he came here, and the equipment manager for the Eagles took him down to Chicago. They got a special helmet made for him where it doesn't cut his forehead anymore. And, of course, he's happy about that. And so is his new wife.
McNabb throws. Intercepted. Intercepted by Aaron Beasley. Beasley bringing it back to midfield and into Philadelphia territory. Now the Eagles want to say that ball hit the turf.
Donovan McNabb, it's a play they ran a few plays ago, and it does not look like it hits the turf. It hits Beasley's leg. No, it's his hand. It knocks it up. He makes a nice catch, and it returns.
Returns it for 25 yards. Now, the fans here have seen the replay up here on the board, and Andy Reid is having a discussion down below with Jerry Austin.
Well, Andy Reid should have looked up and watched the replay because the replay shows you, watch it, I think that's a pretty good shot. This football never hits the ground.
Well, here's Jerry Austin.
Philadelphia is challenging the call on the field of an interception.
Well, we'll find out when we come back if Andy Reid has gotten some bad advice on this. 14-10, Eagles. We're in the middle of a replay challenge here, and what I feel is an ill-advised challenge by Andy Reid. It may cost him a timeout that he could well use later on.
Well, I'm pretty sure it will, and the football, it gets away from Donovan McNabb. That is not one of his better throws, but it hits the right arm of Aaron Beasley. Yeah, oh, that's a nice shot. You could really see it that time. Hits his right arm, goes up into his legs, it's intercepted. Who upstairs told Andy Reid to challenge it? That's what, Greg, you want to know and I want to know. Timeouts in the second half are precious.
After reviewing the play, the defender gets his hand under the ball. It is an interception. Is he down by contact? His heel touches the helmet of number 87, but he does not have control of the ball at that time. Therefore, he's not down by contact, and he gets the result of the play. So the call stands as made on the field. Philadelphia's charged with their first timeout.
Let's backtrack a little. We could do this pretty well, too.
I think we just found out why Andy Reid made that challenge.
He could have been challenging, was he down? Because that would be, I don't know, 20 yards?
25.
That's it. Correct me again.
25-yard difference in field position.
But, to go back to the play, the football got away from Donovan McNabb. That was the second time they've ran the exact same play. Aaron Beasley, I know, diagnosed it, knew it was a play he'd already seen. He was making the break as soon as he saw the quarterback set up, so he was going to be there to make a play regardless.
Brian Westbrook walking back onto the field.
What was that?
I don't know. I got a question for you, Mr. Sims. If Andy Reid is questioning whether he was down by contact or not, rather than whether it was an interception or not, does it cost him a timeout?
Sure, he was wrong. Oh, if he'd have been right, if that's what he asked the official,
right.
No, it would not have cost him a timeout, no. I like it when you ask me questions. Because you want to stun me, don't you?
Curtis Martin straight ahead to the 46. Mark Simoneau back onto the field and making that stop.
But I would always trick him, Greg, and know the answer. But this is a big drive for the New York Jets. And I think Boomer Esiason said some interesting things at halftime talking about this game. Testaverde played well. He threw the touchdown. The stats look good. Chad Pinkett's come in and done well, but they haven't gotten any points. So that's what everybody's going to judge. In good field position, it's been going your way. You need to take advantage of it.
Play fake. Pennington on the roll. Throws. It is caught by Beck. Anthony Beck to the 30-yard line and a first down for the Jets.
And, Greg, we've had many chances. You talked to Chad Pennington, and we talked about it earlier. The play action fake, he really is. Chad Pennington and Peyton Manning are the best at it in the NFL. You could tell. You could see the ball was just tipped. Didn't throw it exactly where he wanted it. But those play action fakes are so good. That's why the tight end was so wide open. The defense thought it was a run.
Swing and Jonathan Carter in his wide receiver. Pennington swings it out here to the near side. Martin. And Martin stood up. Just back to the line of scrimmage. Carlos Emmons, number 51. The first man to hit it.
And when you watch games in the National Football League, you only get so many chances every game. You dominate play for a while, those are your chances to score. You get a couple breaks, you get good field position. The Jets now have had it for about a full quarter, and they have gotten no points out of it.
This is the seventh Jets drive, and every one of them has gone into Philadelphia territory, and only two ended up in points. The tight end inside the 20 and a first down.
Boy, that is really the execution, except for Curtis Conway missing that one route adjustment. Again, the blitz, the throw into pressure. Baker makes the catch. This was a lot of 3 days to get ready for all this blitzing, and the Jets used those 3 days very well.
18-yard line. Two tight ends and Curtis Martin in the backfield. Straight drop this time, and Pennington goes down. Andy Kalu registers the first Philadelphia sack of the day.
Yeah, and it goes against Jason Fabini up the top of your screen. It's just so fast, there's nothing anybody can do, and Pennington does a good job just hanging on to the football.
Loss of seven makes it second and 17. We're in the final minute of the third quarter. Martin. Martin breaks it outside. 15, 10, 5, and out of bounds just short of the goal line. Clinton Hart saved the touchdown.
Well, we talked about it earlier. Curtis Martin's got that look again. Every time you think, well, he's slowing down, he's not going to be able to get it done, breaks tackles, takes it to the outside, and then outruns the Philadelphia Eagles defense down inside the 5-yard line.
21-yard pickup, first and goal for the Jets.
And you know what that play was? You see what Curtis Martin has done today. Second and long, Greg. What do the Jets and the West Coast offense people like to do? Get back on track. It almost always means a draw play on second and long.
A feel-good play.
There you go.
Lamont Jordan.
You lose 7 yards on first down. That almost always says, well, you're not going to score points. The draw play to Curtis Martin sets up this, his substitute, Lamont Jordan, for the touchdown.
With 4 seconds to play here in the third quarter, Jordan with the touchdown that puts the Jets on top and gives us our fourth lead change of the day. Ryan's kick is good. Lamont Jordan, his third touchdown of the season. And the Jets jump back on top, 17-14.
Yes, whether it's a drug ring or a bank robbery, the FBI's undercover team will take on any identity to solve crimes from the inside.
Emmy winner Joe Pantoliano is the handler. Don't miss an all-new episode Friday at 10, 9 Central on CBS. James Thrash and Sean Morey are deep for the Eagles. And this play will take us to the end of the third quarter. From the 8 it's Thrash. 25. Tripped up at about the 28 or 29 yard line. There's a penalty marker down back up here at the 45 yard line. And Jets are offside on the kickoff.
Offside, 37 of the kicking team. 5-yard penalty, and we will re-kick.
Mike,
that's the end
Mike
of the
Westhoff
third
quarter. With a few words for number 37 of the New York Jets, who was offside. David Young, the rookie.
Well, we got to find out if the Eagles want them to kick it off again. And if they do, they're going to have to get rid of a lot of cheerleaders who just ran on the field. And Andy, there's the cheerleaders. Look at them. I'm telling you what, they only
That's
got like 60
of them.
Well, they're going to stay
the
out there.
The discussion is when there's a kick at the end of a quarter, the team that has been fouled has a choice of which direction to kick. The Eagles is choosing for the quarter to end and for the Jets to kick in the other direction.
There you go, Jerry Austin with Andy Reid's decision. So that is the end of our third quarter with the score, the Jets 17 and the Eagles 14. We'll come back to Lincoln Financial Field after this message and a word from your local station. This one is going to be picked up. 7-yard line by Thrash, 25, 35, 40, and across the 45-yard line, a fine return by James Thrash. Lamont Jordan, his touchdown has the Jets on top, but the Eagles have come right back with a terrific return.
Tonight on TV's most watched new drama, a 30-year-old murder of a police officer caught on tape.
Will recorded clues lead to his killer? Don't miss an all-new cold case tonight after after 60 Minutes on CBS. Buck Baldwin and Richie in the backfield. McNabb comes up throwing and hits James Thrash on the near side across midfield into Jet territory. Second and 5. And we're talking with Herm Edwards as he came into our meeting room last night. Asked him how it feels to come back here to Philadelphia, and were the fans good to him? And he said, yeah, they were.
Yeah, he really meant it too. He says, hey, they love you down here. Herm Edwards, a free agent, came in and started from opening day with the Philadelphia Eagles and made quite a few big plays as a player down here.
Buckhalter left side inside the 40, first down. Herman Edwards played here with the Eagles from 1977 to 1985. Picked off his share of passes, including number 11 here. Not your fault. You hit your man in stride. And, of course, there is the play, picking up the Joe Pisarcik fumble, the one for which he is most remembered, many would think. But as you said, he said his favorite moment is coming in here as a rookie free agent, making the team, eventually heading to a Super Bowl with the Eagles.
That's right.
This way, this way. Yeah.
First down, Jet 38. McNabb on the move, looking, and threw it away. Pretty good coverage by the Jets secondary, second and 10.
Excellent job by the Jets secondary. Good job by Donovan McNabb. And, you know, Greg, we've talked a lot about him today, and doesn't seem like they've been on the field a whole lot since those first two touchdown drives, but he's conducted himself well. The statistics are pretty good. Really, only one bad throw, the interception, seemed to get away from him just a little bit, but decision-making, his body language, the bounce in his step, he's picked a couple spots to run, which has been good timing, so confident. Good way to get it back.
Buckhalter runs out of room to run as the Jet defense converges. And as you said, he has pretty much done everything. What they really wanted to see out of him was a looseness and ability to run the way they know he can. He's done a little of that. The short passes, he's only had one completion longer than 15 yards. Unfortunately for McNabb, if things stay the way they are, it's that one interception which turned into the go-ahead touchdown that people are going to remember most.
Well, I don't know. Look, the team still had to drive down there for the touchdown, so... You know, sometimes these turnovers and leading to points is a little skewed, but I just think it's been what they want to see today from Donovan McNabb, execute the offense. Find the open receiver, make the throw, and he's done that pretty well.
On third and nine, he has time wide open, and he overthrew Freddie Mitchell, number 84. And we're going to get a holding call against the Eagles.
I think this is a position where the Jets might have to take this penalty. As I look at it, it would be a 54 or 55-yard field goal. And Herman Edwards, yes, in the
back. Illegal hands to the face. 66 offense, 10 yards, repeat third down.
Bobby Williams, good shot right in front of McNabb. You can see his hands on Kenyatta Wright's face mask, and Freddie Mitchell wide open down the field, but Akers, strong leg, Greg, you can't give him a chance to kick the tying field goal.
David Akers has a long of 57 this year, and has been two straight Pro Bowls. Herman Edwards does not want to give him a shot at tying the game right here. Instead, it's a third and 19. Inside the 45-yard line. Abraham and Ray Green with the stop, and there's a marker down.
And the one thing you don't want to do is a defense, third and very long.
Illegal contact, 21 of the defense, 5 yards, automatic first down.
Oh, two costly things on that play. Number one, John Abraham limping off in pain. And secondly, the penalty on Aaron Beasley right there.
Boy, was that the penalty?
Illegal contact was the call.
It looked like he did it in the 5-yard area of the line of scrimmage. Boy, John Abraham is in a lot of pain on the sideline. Runner Deuce Staley lands on the inside of his right leg.
Brian Thomas has replaced Abraham. It's first down for the Eagles. McNabb over the middle, incomplete. Todd Pinkston had it and dropped it.
You know, and listen to the fans. This is a drive to tie the score. They're on the 42-yard line going in, and it's all negative right now, and it stems from the fact
that he overthrew a wide open Freddie Mitchell that wasn't going to count anyway. And look, I know that you're right when you come to these games to do whatever you want, but why would you be booing in a situation like this? Do you want your team to win? It amazes me sometimes.
This is Buckwalter on second and 10 inside the 40 to about the 38.
Am I wrong?
No, well, I understand.
Am I perceiving it wrong? I don't know. Your team, you help your team here in a situation like this.
I think your point is that by exercising your right to do and feel however you want to feel, you are not doing your team a service.
Well, yeah, I don't know. Well, why would you come to the game and have such negative thoughts anyway all the time? I understand the Eagles have been struggling, but they're doing okay today. They're giving you reasons to cheer, to be positive. Enjoy the experience of coming to the game.
Third and six. Quick drop, quick pass, almost intercepted on the far side by Ray Mickens.
Ray Mickens, if you watch what he does the whole play, he is covering the inside receiver. Look at him. Inside, he watches the quarterback, falls off of his guy, and gets in front of James Thrash. Here he is. That is really well done. He knew he had helped in the inside with Sam Garnes and does an excellent job getting in the way and really should have made the interception.
So David Akers gets to try his 56-yard field goal now. On the way. Short and off the mark. Jets hold on to their three-point lead. 11:33 to play in the fourth.
David Akers, field goal attempt to tie the game, came up short.
Jets with the lead and the ball from their own 46. Santana Moss gets a nice crackback block across midfield, looking for first down yardage, and is about a yard short of it at the Philadelphia 45.
Curtis Conway on the outside comes down. Look at the reverse. I don't know if we're going to be able to see it. Ooh, we did catch a little shot of it. He catches Michael Lewis, the safety. It was legal, it was clean, and it was flush. Good, really good mixture. The Jets, the play action passes, they've been alert for the blitzes, the reverse play, the flea flicker.
On second and one, Pennington still with the ball, throwing over the middle, intercepted. Michael Lewis with the ball. Back to the 30, to the 40. Gerald Sowell with the tackle.
Michael Lewis just got knocked down and blocked to the ground. On the blitz, he recovers and makes an outstanding play.
Off the turnover, the Eagle offense back in business at their own 43-yard line.
Two turnovers for the Jets today. It's not a common thing for them.
Right here.
Across the 45 to the 47. And let's go back to the interception, which came off a terrific play fake by Pennington.
Michael Lewis watching come up on the run fake and then watching retreat and get in the way of the receiver coming across the field. Chad Pennington, we talked about it, he is excellent. This takes some courage because you don't know. If they don't buy it, you get hit from behind and fumble, steps up, never sees Michael Lewis dropping back into coverage.
Second and four. Buckhalter across the 45 of the Jets to about the 42 and a first down, and we go down to Armand.
Greg, the dynamic pass rusher for the Jets, John Abraham, was in considerable pain as he hobbled to the locker room with what is described as a groin injury on his right side. I'm told he's in there to get it wrapped. His return is up in the air. Back to you.
All right, Armand, thanks. So meanwhile, and, you know, the injury situation is nothing new to any team. There are other players that have to step up. In this case, Jets will look for number 99, Brian Thomas. On first down. McNabb on the move. Gonna run with it. And is out of bounds, just short of the Jets' 30-yard line. Victor Hobson forced him out. We go to Jim Nance in New York for an NFL Today update.
All right, we've got 12 and a half to go at Indianapolis, and rookie Dominic Davis is in for the second time today. He's over 100 yards rushing, 27-21 Colts. Let's go back to Greg and Phil.
All right, Jim, thank you. Dominic Davis chalked up 129 yards rushing against this Jets team last week. Donovan McNabb just rushed for a first down. First down, Philadelphia at the Jets 32.
Let's go, Tommy.
Staley. For a couple for the period.
You know, so much of this league is about, as Herman Edwards said, one of the reasons he thought his team was 2-4, none of his guys were making plays when it came time to decide the outcome of the game. And he means in the fourth quarter. Well, the last couple weeks, last week, Vinny Testaverde led them on a game-winning drive. Before, the week before, they just played well all over. But when you get in situations like this, a defensive lineman sack the quarterback, a defensive back reading, make the play.
McNabb throws and hits number 82, L.J. Smith, the tight end, inside the 25. Close to another first down.
And if you're
it
on
is
the
first down. Sorry,
sorry, Greg. But if you're on the Eagles side, well, just keep putting it in the hands of your quarterback. Donovan McNabb making good decision. Good hard throw to L.J. Smith.
Earlier Jets turnover. The Eagles failed to convert. They blocked the punt, didn't convert on that. Here they are knocking on the door at the 22-yard line. Staley, left side, cuts it back, 15, 10, to the 5-yard line. Sam Coward tracked him down.
Good running, good blocking up front, and the New York Jets, when you get them out in space sometimes, when you get to the outside, you spread the field, I think that's when they have a hard time making plays. John Wellborn makes a nice block on Victor Hobson. Deuce Staley breaks a few tackles and picks up a big game.
Deuce Staley comes up with his longest run of the year, an 18-yarder, first and goal, Philadelphia, just inside the 5. Still has it. Looking, throws, touchdown, John Ritchie. Ritchie's second touchdown receiving this year. And it puts the Eagles back on top. Our fifth lead change of the day. Akers' kick is good. 6:42 to play. Fourth quarter. McNabb's touchdown pass has the Eagles up 21-17.
He sneaks behind the line of scrimmage. The linebackers have to be ready for this play. The Eagles run it every single week. Ever since Andy Reid has been with them, they run that exact play. The Jets run it, and it still fools their defense.
Michael Bates from the 2. 25, 30, 35, and a fine return out to the 37-yard line. Donovan McNabb, only his third touchdown pass of the season, but it puts the Eagles up 21-17.
To it.
From the 37, go to the ground game. Curtis Martin, nothing there. Corey Simon led the charge. No gain, second and 10.
Indy Kalu caused the pileup for the Philadelphia Eagles and didn't let Curtis Martin have any running lanes.
coming up on 6 minutes to play here in the fourth quarter.
Whiting, Corey Simon, the pressure they play past. Nobody open, and Chad Pennington did a really good job of pulling the football down and not forcing it down the field.
Time over the middle and hits his man right close to the first down marker. Santana Moss's forward progress is going to be marked, looks like about a yard shy.
Interesting decision for Herm Edwards here. It's going to be fourth and probably a little less than a yard. Santana Moss, he knows how far he has to go down the field, coming back, protecting the football, going towards the quarterback. Made him come up about a half a yard short.
They will go for it on fourth and one.
I like the call. Your defense has not been stopping the Eagles offense that easily.
Now Herman Edwards wants a timeout. Timeout stops the clock with 4:34 to play in the fourth. Timeouts remaining. This is a big moment in this game.
It is. Two timeouts left. 4 minutes and 34 seconds. Fourth and less than 1 yard. Hey, this is, I think it's the right decision. Your defense is not stopping the Eagles that easily. You take the chance right now.
Lamont Jordan diving. Did he get there? This is going to be awfully close.
Looks like he's going to be short. Either way you look at it. I watched both officials come running in. Both sides had the runner looking like he's about a foot short.
If the Jets are short, this place will erupt.
Ran the football over Jason Fabini, and Dave Zott had the big running back in. They are a defense that likes to penetrate. In other words, they line up in between your players and they just try to get into the backfield. Indy Kalu is one of the guys that causes trouble again.
Phil, we were talking about it during the timeout. One of our favorite people, Tom Moore, the offensive coordinator at the Indianapolis Colts, greeted us at the start of the season by saying, let the second guessing begin.
Well,
you can almost feel it going to happen with the New York Jets and Herm Edwards in this quarterback situation.
Well, absolutely. Quarterback situation, going for on fourth down there. Those are the tough decisions the coach has to make.
Buckhoff is still on his feet. Spinning for a first down inside the 35-yard line.
That's a good example why Herm Edwards went for it on fourth down. They're not doing extremely well against the pass. Your best pass rusher is out. You're not stopping the run that well either. Just extra effort does it for Karell Buckhalter.
Sam Garns is on the field on the far side. He's being tended to. And the clock has stopped with 4:13 to play.
More to come. And I'm not so sure all of it will be around that fourth down call by Herman Edwards. I agree with you. The way that the Philadelphia Eagles have been on offense tonight, he may not have gotten the football back.
Yeah, that's right. I know. We're talking about the quarterback decision. And, you know, as soon as Herm Edwards decided he was going to do this, and When I said something to him, he said, look, I thought about this for weeks. And he says, we showed it earlier, he knows his players. He knows these quarterbacks, and he knows his team. And that decision he made, Greg, my opinion is, I agreed with it. I thought it was a good plan, a good way to get Chad Pennington back in the flow. It looked wonderful for a long time today, but when you make these decisions, we all sit back and is what Tom Moore say, or he says, Shakespeare says we're all geniuses after the fact. So you make these decisions and you take the criticism for it when they don't work out.
The Eagles, 181 rushing yards today, a season high. Deuce Taylor, right side. And this play stood up by Mo Lewis on the near side. And Mo comes up with a looks like a little bit of a stinger. Timeout on the field. 3:43 to play. Staley off the left side. As we come up on 3.5 minutes to play, and the Jets use their third and final timeout to stop the clock. So 3:34 to play. And with third and six, the Jets can no longer stop the clock. Here in Philadelphia, all the talk will be about that man, Donovan McNabb, tomorrow.
Oh, that's something different from before? I was just listening to, when you walk in the hallways here, before the game, you can hear all the radio talk shows on, and everybody was in total agreement benching. That was it. No doubt. Benching. Should have been out. Take him out. Take him out now. If he doesn't start out well, take him out. If he doesn't, take him out. So, Andy Reid, he has a history with this quarterback. I gotta believe that they've gone to the NFC Championship game twice. You see his stats here. Andy Reid is going to stake his coaching career on Donovan McNabb. You know what? That's okay.
Keep this in mind. These Eagles have gone 8-2 in the last 10 games of each of their last three seasons. McNabb, quick pass this side. Kingston. Kingston looking for first down yardage, reaching for it and has it.
You talk about making a play when you need one. McNabb, Andy Reid, they picked the right guy. Pinkston goes up against Mickens, Ray Mickens. He is the smallest defender on the field. That gives you a better chance just because of this. If you can't fake him out, maybe you can overpower him and get those extra yards for a first down.
Only Pinkston's second catch of the day. It's a big one, and the Jets can't stop the clock. Deuce Staley. Staley, put up 16.
Boy, you go back to that third down call by the Eagles. It was safe. It took care of the blitz by the New York Jets. You get rid of the football. You keep the clock moving. And then, lo and behold, one of your wide receivers makes a big play for you.
You know, these New York Jets also have had a habit of starting slowly. And when Herm Edwards came in, that's the first thing I asked him last night. And I was expecting some reasonable, thought-out, philosophical explanation. I don't know.
There's a lot of really I don't knows in the NFL.
Staley inside the 15 to the 12, and that'll get us to the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to play in Philadelphia. The Eagles on the verge of going over the 500 mark. Here in Philadelphia, the Eagles at the Jets 13-yard line, holding on to a 21-17 lead, and the Jets are out of timeouts, unable to stop the clock. Third and two. Buckholter and Richie in the backfield behind McNabb. Buckholter gets the call, and he'll be short of a first down. And with a fourth and one, the field goal unit has not yet come onto the field. Those of you expecting to see 60 Minutes, you're watching the NFL on CBS and our game between the New York Jets and the Philadelphia Eagles. Greg Dumble with Phil Simms and Armin Katsayan. Our score is 21-17 Eagles. 60 Minutes will be seen in its entirety immediately following this game, except on the West Coast. And Philadelphia calls a timeout here using their second. They have one remaining, and I imagine the conversation here, Phil, revolves around the possibility of a blocked field goal.
Well, I think you're right, Greg, and I was going to give you some scenarios for that, but he's already sending the field goal team out there. I'm looking over your shoulder, so I see David Akers going out there to kick the field goal. I thought they might go for it, get the first down in the game, and if you don't, remember the New York Jets, look where they are, where you've left them. No timeouts left. That would be very tough for him to get down the field and score a touchdown. Pretty exciting game today, though. I think we were prepared for this, and for the last 2 days, we're going, boy, oh, boy, what's going to happen?
What's going to happen?
3-3 is going to be the score, but it's been exciting. A lot of plays made by both sides of the football.
30-yard field goal attempt by Akers. Kick is on the way, and it is good. So Akers extends the Eagles' lead to 24-17. Well, the great quarterback experiment for the New York Jets, how did it go? Vinny Testaverde played well. Off the flea flicker, he hit Santana Moss with a 60-yard touchdown pass. On came Chad Pennington, and Pennington started slowly and had this interception, all of which will open things up to Herm Edwards this week with the press, I am sure. Take a look at the numbers. 112 yards for each of them.
Well, I thought they both played well. Of course, the big play, Chad Pennington's interception. I know he never saw Michael Lewis because he was fooled and all the way up near the line of scrimmage for the run play, but made a nice adjustment, turning around and making the interception. The play that put Vinny Testaverde over the top, the flea flicker for the touchdown, and it's not over, Greg.
Oh, it never is until the final
down. That's right, minute 12.
Several heroes for the Eagles today. Correll Buchalter, 100 yards rushing and a couple of touchdowns.
Yeah, I was very impressed with how he ran the football. Speed, he looked faster, and he ran with decisiveness and power.
Michael Bates, 5 career kickoff returns for touchdown. 20. Almost broke it outside, and a late flag flies from Jerry Austin. And it's going to be against the Jets.
Holding, number 86, during the run back, 10 yards, first down.
Penalty is on Chris Baker of the Jets, and our NFL.com question of the week. Who's done the best coaching job so far this year? Log on, cast your vote at NFL.com. So the Jets have 90 yards to go in 1:06 and no timeout. Conway to the near side of the field, Moss to the top of the screen. Trevett in the slot. Curtis Martin right up the middle to the 16-yard line. 6 yards, 2nd and 4. For the 6th time in 7 games this season, the Jets have allowed more than 140 yards rushing. Pennington stepping up, throwing out to the side. Fole out of bounds with a first down. 40 seconds to play.
You look at this game, we've spent a lot of time, of course, talking about the New York Jets, but the Philadelphia Eagles. And it has been rough. And they might be the ugliest 3-3 team
that I've even witnessed myself coming into this game. But now, if they hold on here, 4-3 after the injuries, that bad play by their quarterback, all the questions, and to be 4-3 is a statement, a tremendous statement about Andy Reid and some of the good things they've done here.
Pennington pass, incomplete, may have been tipped at the line as he let it go.
Pass,
37 seconds to play.
And you know, Greg, we talk so much about it too, and we're always talking about the league and everything. After eight games, if you can be 4-4, that is, you're in a good position, because now you're just looking for one little hot streak that puts you over the top to get you in the playoffs.
Pennington up the seam, has his man, and that is Curtis Conway. And Conway out across the 45-yard line. Now with 21 seconds to play.
Well, I tell you what, I really mean this. I might have warmed Vinny Testaverde up and get him ready, because can Chad Pennington drop back if you get one play left and you got to throw it over 50 yards in the air from the line of scrimmage? So you're going to be behind it. You're talking about a 60-yard throw. I don't know if he can do that, but I know Vinny Testaverde can.
Even at 39 years of age, Vinny will be 40 next month. We still talk about him in terms of he throws lasers when he's on the money.
Hey, forget us. What the opposing coaches say. So, Jets need to pick up a few yards to get one shot into the end zone.
Santana Moss, incomplete.
That's where you see the rustiness by Chad Pennington. Once he gets into the groove, that is like automatic. He never lets the football slip out of his hand and get away from him and gets it off target like he did on that throw.
Cheering crowd here, and not very many have left Lincoln Financial Field. 3rd and 10.
They're still looking for that one play to get a few yards.
Hits his man at the 45, and Santana Moss is down at the 42. Eight. Trying to stop the clock. 5 seconds, 4, 3, and they stop it. 3 seconds to play.
Excellent job. Give yourself one chance in the end zone.
And now the Eagles will call timeout to talk about how they'll defend this last play.
And that's a good timeout too, Greg. Just think, if you're a football coach, all the different scenarios that come up during a game, it's almost countless. And I don't know if you can cover them all. So a situation like this, you just want to go over all your rules, what we're doing, make sure you're in an end zone. And you hear this all the time from an ex-player that we talk about, when the Hail Mary or the last ditch effort is thrown in the end zone, what are you supposed to do? Knock it down. That's right.
Knock it down, try real hard not to commit pass interference in the end zone.
Well, that's right, too. The game cannot end on a defensive penalty.
Line of scrimmage is the 42, and we'll see who the Jets have in there for wide receiver.
And these plays have a greater chance now, more than ever, of succeeding because of the talent of the wide receivers, how versatile they are, the way they can jump.
Moss, Corbett, Conway, Kevin Swain are the receivers. Pennington launches it to the near side. It falls incomplete at the goal line. Hard-earned victory by the Philadelphia Eagles. Chad Pennington's comeback story not written the way he'd like to see it written. For Phil Simms and Armin Kassayan, Greg Gumbel saying so long from Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia. The Eagles defeat the